Hey, Covenant Kids, we are so glad that you're here with us today. We have some special guests, so be on the lookout during the service today. And also, Grace is here with me, and I hear we have a new Grace song.
You're exactly right. We do have a new praise song. We have recorded Jesus Jump for you guys to praise with us today. So wherever you're at, stand up, let's hear your loudest, best praise voices, and let's see your best praise dance moves. Come join us.
There is a fountain that drowns sorrow. There is incredible. It's better than I ever imagined.
Hey, Megan.
Oh, hey, Grace. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
What you got going on?
I got my wedding pictures back. You can set it over here.
Is that okay?
Have a seat. Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah. Just be careful.
Okay.
Set it down.
Yeah. Very careful. Yeah. Oh, these pictures are gorgeous.
Thank you. I just got them back.
They look lovely.
Thank you.
What's in your hand? What are you looking at there?
Oh,
another one.
Yeah, it's just a little bit bigger. You know, you can see it a little bit better if it's bigger.
That's what you were admiring.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah, look at it. I mean, the dress, and you can see my train, and the flowers. I don't know if you know, but we did those ourselves.
Yeah.
And I got such a good tan going on, and my hair was perfect. My makeup. This is probably the best bridal I've ever seen. I'm not even kidding. Here, take a look.
Oh, yeah. Let me. Yeah, good. Thank you.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Wow.
Did you see this one down here?
We
went down to the creek on that one.
Oh, wow. That's adventurous.
Yeah, and this, I've got my dog in this one. You see that?
Oh, I like that one, little Maxie.
Yeah. I like this one, but I think he just kind of steals focus.
From?
Me.
Oh.
That's me on my wedding day.
Megan, how long have you been sitting here staring at your photos?
It's probably only been about 2 hours.
Two hours?
Yeah.
120 minutes.
Yeah.
Of staring at your...
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just a little bit worried.
Why?
Well,
Do you see them?
Oh, I see them. They're beautiful. They're gorgeous.
Yeah.
Most beautiful pictures I've ever seen.
Thank you.
But I'm just a little concerned with how you spent your 2 hours. Because...
What do you mean?
Well, I'm just worried because God's given you a lot of gifts other than beauty. He's given you the ability to talk to others.
Oh.
He's
You're
given
right.
you kindness, he's
yeah.
given you friendship, he's given you wonderful family members, and you could use all those things to minister and share his love. And I love that you have the gift of beauty. It's wonderful.
Thank you.
But can't you use some of your other gifts to glorify him in 2 hours? How many people could you talk to about Jesus in 2 hours?
Yeah, I guess you're right.
How many scriptures could you read in 2 hours?
Probably a decent amount.
How much prayer time could you have with God in 2 hours?
Oh, thanking him for how good I looked in these pictures? You're right.
Well, you know that star? At least we'd be talking to him.
That's true.
You know, Megan, all this kind of makes me think of a story in the Bible about Jesus and some of his friends in a garden. I know you're a Bible scholar, so you probably know what I'm talking about.
The Garden of Gethsemane.
Yeah, I think that you might could benefit from that story a little bit.
What do you mean? What part?
Well, I think that maybe we need to take the focus off of us and we need to focus a little bit more on what God has for us and how God can use us.
Yeah.
So maybe let's try to push Megan to the back burner and let's try to put God on the front burner and see what he has for us this
week.
Let's go learn a little bit about Jesus and his friends and see if that helps you out at all.
Okay. Do you want to take one of these home with you?
Oh, yeah,
here.
I'd love to.
Here,
thank you.
Well, these actually go together. The frames match.
But can we take them?
Yeah, you can.
Oh, good.
I'll get more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. I love that. I don't have children yet, so that's
perfect. They can go on your piano.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. Perfect.
Great. Okay. Wonderful. All
right. I'm gonna take this one because.
Oh, naturally. Yeah. But not that one because it has someone else in it.
Yeah. The church probably needs that one, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Let's go.
Okay.
Humility. Putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Matthew, chapter 26, verses 36 through 56.
For months, the Jewish religious leaders had been plotting to silence Jesus.
He called us pretenders, snakes!
On the Sunday before Passover, Jesus entered Jerusalem to great cheers from the crowds.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord!
But even as the crowd swarmed in to see what Jesus would do and say, one of Jesus' closest followers, Judas, went to the religious leaders with a very sneaky plan.
What are you willing to give me if I deliver him over to you?
How about a cool 30 pieces of silver?
Jesus knew these plans, but he also knew that his mission was to face those who hated him and let them take him without defending himself. He prepared his closest friends for this during a Passover meal and then afterwards led them out of the city toward the Mount of Olives. Judas had already left them.
In a little while, you will no longer see me. Then after a little while, you will see me. I came from the Father and entered the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father.
The air cooled as the evening darkened.
This very night, you will all turn away because of me.
Peter, the most outspoken of Jesus' friends, quickened his step and tightened his hand on the sword he was carrying.
All the others may turn away because of you, but I never will.
What I'm about to tell you is true. It will happen tonight. Before the rooster crows, you will say three times that you don't know me.
I may have to die with you, but I will never say I don't know you.
Me too.
Same.
By the time Jesus and his friends reached the Garden of Gethsemane, they were exhausted.
Sit here while I go over there and pray.
As the other disciples settled in on the cold, rough ground, Jesus took Peter, James, and John along with him to a grove of ancient olive trees. The weight of what was coming pressed down on him.
My soul is very sad. I feel close to death. Stay here. Keep watch with me.
We're here for you.
We got this.
Prayers. The three friends found seats among the knotted tree roots, and Jesus went on a little further. Then suddenly, he fell down on the ground, face first into the dirt. Words poured out from deep inside.
My Father, if it is possible, take this cup of suffering away from me. But let what you want be done, not what I want.
After a short time, Jesus returned to his friends. They had all fallen into restless sleep. Jesus touched Peter's arm.
What? Huh? We're just praying.
Couldn't you men keep watch with me for 1 hour? Watch and pray. Then you won't fall into sin when you are tempted. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak.
We'll stay awake this time.
Got you covered.
Again, Jesus threw himself down to pray. His pain was so deep, blood and sweat beaded on his forehead.
My Father, is it possible for this cup to be taken away? But if I must drink it, may what you want be done.
Jesus returned to his friends once more to find them still sleeping. The agony in his spirit forced Jesus to lay his heart out to God once more. He prayed the desperate words again, begging God to take away what was coming, and at the same time, revealing his complete trust in God's plan.
Let what you want be done, not what I want.
At last, Jesus knew the time had come. He returned to find Peter, James, and John buried deep in sleep. Beyond them, his other followers slept too.
Are you still sleeping and resting?
The disciples struggled through a fog of sleep, blinking and yawning. Below them, torchlight showed an angry mob climbing up the hill. The men were waving swords and clubs, shouting as they came.
Look, the hour has come. The Son of Man is about to be handed over to sinners. Get up, let us go. Here comes the one who is handing me over to them.
Jesus' friends staggered to their feet, and Peter clutched his sword. As the mob marched closer, they could see the man in front of the mob. It was their friend Judas.
Judas? What are you doing?
The mob had been sent by the Jewish religious leaders. Judas had already explained to them that he would greet Jesus with a kiss, so they would know exactly which man to arrest.
Greetings, teacher.
Judas ignored the other disciples and went directly to Jesus, kissing him on the cheek in greeting. Jesus drew back and looked Judas directly in the face.
Friend, do what you came to do.
The mob surged forward as the disciples just stood there, frozen and confused. As men grabbed Jesus, Peter suddenly sprang to life, awkwardly drawing his sword.
Should we use our swords?
Peter didn't wait for an answer, but he struck out wildly. His blade sliced right through the ear of the high priest's servant.
Oh!
Stop this!
Jesus touched the servant's ear. Immediately, he was healed.
Put your sword back in its place. Do you think I can't ask my father for help? He would send an army of more than 70,000 angels right away. But then how would the scriptures come true? They say it must happen in this way.
Jesus turned back to the mob and the men who held him. They hovered there, uncertain, in the flickering light of their torches.
Am I leading a band of armed men against you? Do you have to come out with swords and clubs to capture me? Every day I sat in the temple courtyard teaching, and you didn't arrest me. But all this has happened so that the words of the prophets would come true.
No one could respond to Jesus. Instead, they arrested him and led him away. And his friends who said they'd be with him through anything ran away. Jesus made the choice that would bring life to everyone, but that would cost him everything.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
And we love you and we miss you.
And we'll see you soon.